No justice!
No peace!
We're at the precipice of a massive industrial revolution, and autonomous trucking will be the crux of that.
It's a job that isn't for everyone, but the one that keeps the world alive.
At a time of widespread shutdowns, truck drivers form the lifeblood of our economy.
During the pandemic, truck drivers were hailed as essential heroes. Now, 5 years later, the industry that powered the economy is shifting gears towards self-driving trucks. The question is whether future becomes reality before workers and regulators push back.
This is game time.
Everything around you was most likely brought to you by a truck. Just within the United States, trucks account for nearly 80% of intrastate shipments and are involved in the supply chain of all top 10 commodities. But now, the nearly $1 trillion a year freight industry in the US is starting to look very different. If highways go driverless, the way goods move will change at a national and even international scale.
Autonomous trucking has a ton of economic advantages. We can drive 22 hours without stopping.
Ossa Fischer is president of Aurora, a company that started as a general autonomous driving platform back in 2017. Today, it runs fully driverless 18-wheelers on public freeways between Dallas and Houston.
They've actually found fuel efficiency as well, given the consistency of the Aurora driver. So we've driven the same freight both manually and in autonomy and seen 14% fuel savings, which is really fantastic when that is one of the main cost drivers. And then, of course, insurance. We believe that over time, with our safety record, 3 million miles in autonomy already, 50,000 completely driverless miles with a perfect safety record, that insurance costs over time will also be very favorable.
Let's take a step back and talk about the U.S. trucking industry. At present, that is about a $900 billion market. Maybe the most important pieces are the long-haul trucking market, that's about $300 billion, and then the regional or middle-mile segment is $300 billion.
Santosh Sankar specializes in investing in logistics, transportation technology, and autonomous trucking. Goldman Sachs expects the self-driving truck market to increase by more than 13,000% over the next 4 years, from a mere $130 million in 2026 to $18 billion in 2030.
About 24 states have already established and opened their doors for autonomous freight operations. Texas is out in front in terms of engendering a regulatory environment where technologists can come, harden, and scale these deployments out.
Aurora launched its first fully autonomous long-haul commercial rides from Dallas, Texas to Houston back in April 2025. Our producer got a view from the back seat of one of their new trucks.
What is the best use case for an autonomous truck?
There are lots, but the one that we are really putting our strategy behind are the long haul. So the ones that exceed hours of service limitation, that, you know, where we could drive 20 hours straight without stopping. And that has tremendous benefits, not just for the efficiency and utilization of the truck, which is very important, but important goods that need to be expedited, everything from medical supplies to perishable fruits and vegetables that need to get where they're going very quickly.
For now, a human observer still rides along in Aurora's trucks. The wheel turns itself, but the trust isn't quite there yet.
We should explain what we're actually doing right now. So we are in autonomy, and you can see this is a ride observer, but really does not touch the vehicle at all. You see there's no hands on the wheel, no feet on the pedals, and the observer is here as a request from PACCAR, which is the vehicle manufacturer, but is not required at all for the Aurora driver. So we are in full autonomy right now. We are in driverless mode.
Some of the sensors are our mid-range LiDARs. That's these ones that you see that are round. Those ones can see about 200 meters down the road and detect what is going on in the environment, things like vehicles down the road. Then we have what's proprietary to Aurora, which is the first light LiDAR. If you look at the top there, it's that rectangular one in the middle, and it is the one that allows us to see so far down the road and operate at highway speeds.
So what will it take for trust to build to the point where trucks don't even have steering wheels or brake pedals? Paul Hanapel is working the problem in Europe as head of automotive and logistics at Bitkom, a German digital trade association. He breaks the technology down into 5 levels, the latter 3 of which are stepping stones to full autonomy.
Level 3 means at some points the car takes over the control, for example at a motorway when it's following another car. And there actually the car has a responsibility. For example, it can be on your phone, but at any moment you have to be able to take over or to take back the control. And the biggest jump afterwards is level 4. There you jump into the car, you won't drive it. So you can just go from A to B without driving. But it's important you are always staying in this operational domain. Level 5, at the end, it's not even planned that a person could drive this car. So there is, for example, no steering wheel in this car. The infrastructure of the whole car is made that only software, only the technology is driving the car. There is no assistant driver who could even possibly drive the car.
While the US and China race ahead with real-world testing, Europe's taking the slower route, writing the rule book first. In Germany, autonomous vehicles are not yet fully deployed due to strict regulations. Victoria Brossard is a member of the German Parliament, working to make autonomous vehicles a reality.
In 2017, the German government passed the first law to allow autonomous driving. And in 2021, there was a second law. And now we are allowed to test autonomous driving in Germany up to level 4. In the US, the testing is done before the legislation, so we see that American companies can test their autonomous vehicles on the streets. So we are lagging behind the development in US, but we already have the standards in place.
When it comes to safety, we take it as our highest priority. Unlike in the US, where you can launch something and afterwards the regulators would come in and see if everything was safe. In Europe, you first need to pass that check.
Hendrik Kramer is the CEO of Fernride, a private driverless trucking company that's making waves in Germany. It's the first company to receive certification for an autonomous terminal tractor. Although it's able to operate at ports, it cannot yet operate on public roads.
We are coming from a use case that is automating trucks in container terminals today, so moving cargo in the horizontal transport in confined areas. We have a huge scaling journey ahead of us, also into many defense applications, but also trucking on public roads. There are situations where it comes to its limits. There are situations when it's negotiating with itself. Is it safe enough or not? It always takes a conservative approach. We had a very recent example with a seagull landing in front of an autonomous truck. And a human would recognize, hey, the seagull would just fly away once it comes closer. But our truck recognized it as a large enough object. It stopped for it, waited there for another 10 seconds, and then connected with the remote operator that then connected to that vehicle, saw on the camera stream, OK, it's just a seagull. Continue your mission, autonomous truck, and then we resolved that situation.
If we can work out things like how to recognize a seagull, the benefits from autonomous trucking could be profound, both in safety and in cost savings.
Driving is one of the most complex things humans do every single day, and we don't even know it. And so in that complexity lies an opportunity. If we glance down at our phone, if we glance back at our child, if heaven forbid we've had one glass too many to drink when we're out about town, accidents happen and they're dire. 40,000 people die on American roadways every single year. That is like a 737 falling from the sky every week. If a plane fell from the sky every week, we wouldn't stand for it. Autonomous vehicles don't get tired. They certainly don't drink. They are always on. And they have superhuman capabilities, like being able to see all the way around their heads.
While autonomous trucks could be safer and more reliable, the big question for business comes down to cost. Which will be cheaper, man or machine? Goldman Sachs analysts expect the cost per mile for driverless trucks to fall from $6.15 this year to $1.89 in 2030. Human-driven trucks could see their costs increase from $2.61 to $2.80 per mile over the same period as driver wages rise. That would put autonomous trucks safely in the lead in the near future, but does that mean an entire workforce gets replaced?
Ich halte es nicht für sinnvoll, weil erstmal die Arbeitsplätze fehlen dann wieder. Zweitens einmal gibt's mehr Unfälle, weil die Pkw-Fahrer ziemlich rücksichtslos gegenüber der Lkw-Fahrer sind.
Some drivers may be anxious, but trucking companies would say the problem today is that we have too few people wanting to drive trucks, not too many.
In the many years I've been covering autonomous trucking, the technology companies will say, look at how difficult it is for the haulage companies to get drivers. The cynic would say they're just not hiring as a hedge against the idea that in the future they won't need them anyway. What is the reality of that labor market dynamic?
What we're effectively seeing is the fact that a lot of the truck drivers are aging and retiring out of the market, right? You're talking about ages between 50 and 65. And when you're operating a vehicle, a heavy machine on the highways over long distances for extended periods of time, experience matters. That's how you engender safety and reliability.
If you look at the average age of a truck driver in the United States, it used to be 35 20 years ago. It's been 45 10 years ago. It's now 55.
Lior Ron is the founder and former CEO at Uber Freight. He's currently the COO of autonomous trucking company Waabi.
We have a chronic shortage of truck drivers in the US today. And I think for the foreseeable future, as you start rolling self-driving gradually, you augment those jobs, you fulfill the empty spots in the demand for those jobs. Many young folks do not want to take on this job, being 300 days on the road, not being able to raise a family, not being able to have predictable access to sleep and food.
35% of the truck drivers we have in Germany have an Eastern European passport, and therefore, once there's a conflict, they need to service in their home countries. And while demand is doubling, supply of drivers is coming even shorter. And the only answer to that is autonomous trucking.
Whatever the obstacles or concerns, whether drivers like it or not, autonomous trucking is seemingly here to stay. And it can bring with it a boost for the economies of both the United States and Europe.
The autonomous industry can add over 450,000 jobs to the American economy over the next 15 years. So not only are we filling a labor gap, but we're also growing the American economy.
We are in those early days of the internet, like 1995, something like that. And we will see this technology scaling in Europe in many different applications and all over the world. And being on the forefront of that is super exciting.
We're really just at the beginning of what I think will be a really profound, meaningful shift for America and the world.